means a credit card only.
Oh, $10.
Oh, all
right. It's part of the experience.
Oh, yeah.
Self-serve ticket kiosks. Excuse me, ma'am? Ma'am, where can I get a... Yeah.
Social media is slowly killing the world.
Yes, it is. So I'm going to post this to IG.
Yeah, exactly.
And YouTube.
Yeah.
And Facebook. TikTok. Definitely some impressive rocket displays out here. Look at this guy over here. Greg giving it scale. Look at this.
It's falling through the atmosphere. That's
a trip. Yeah, I was referring to that thing over there, this landing module. Milky Way ice cream shop? Space puns. Man, it's mad crowded. Well, note to self, for anyone planning to visit the Kennedy Space Center, bus tours are part of the package and are only boarding until 12:30. And it is now 2:30. So, that's a bummer.
Ooh, got a recreation of the Mars rover.
Damn, that's a big thing. Someone give me their best Christian Bale. Where is she?
You know, I never said thank you.
And you'll never have to.
Damn, look at this fucking thing.
Old space person.
Need a space person. Should we stop at the Orbit Cafe? No shortage of low-level puns.
And there looks to be some kind of educational Lego exhibit. I do like Legos.
We go out on a limb and say these are authentic Legos. Oh, definitely. Look at that. Are these X-Men? These inadvertent X-Men? It's definitely.
The painting from Ferris Bueller.
Yeah.
Like, up close, it doesn't really look like anything. Then you zoom out, totally looks like a picture. And it is oddly satisfying.
Oh, shit. Look at that.
I think that's the scale. I'm not mistaken.
Oh, I bet, yeah. Thing's freaking huge.
Oh, cool. See how they live inside their little space habitat.
Quarter scale.
So, Sierra.
Looks like something out of Star Trek.
Oh, yeah. Which is funny because that's.
This guy.
Because this all collapses into this size and inflates out of that. I'm pretty sure Sierra is a.
Damn, that's cool.
Yeah, looks like they've also got some kind of general exhibit on Florida type stuff. History and some of the animal species and such here. Be honest, I'm not entirely sure what this has to do with NASA. All right, we're about to head back outside where they're about to do a tour of that whole rocket garden area, as they call it, find out some cool information.
That little gray one is just the engine?
Yeah, the little gray one, yeah, tiny.
Well, compared to some of this shit.
Bigger than some apartments I've lived in.
Yeah.
Satellite was also our very first commercial satellite, and that was called the Telstar. And the Telstar changed everything. For the first time now, we could have live television pictures from all over the world. So if you watch anything like European soccer or the Olympics from other countries, any of that type of thing, you're watching that on a Telstar satellite. Now, not the original one, but newer updated versions of that. Put a man into space. The engineers at NASA, they were ecstatic. They're patting themselves on the back, very happy. But just 20 days after that launch, that's when President Kennedy went in front of Congress and he issued a goal. He said, we are going to put a man on the moon and return him home safely in this decade. And all the engineers at NASA, when they heard that, they're like, what? We've only sent one guy from here 300 miles from the Bahamas, and now you want us to put a man on the moon and bring him back in 7 years. It took quite a while for those engineers at NASA to wrap their head around that concept.
Also, the Kennedy mission is to everything right here in Florida. Once Houston was up and running, we launched the rockets. Once they clear the tower, we turn control over to Houston. And that's basically how we still do it today.
But down here on the ground, that's about the size of the Germany Castle. We've launched Germany 4 now, and that's up over the air. Not many people have done that up until this point. But the astronauts inside there, they've got a command that nobody had gotten yet. And that was open the door and take a walk outside. So we got the rocket up on the launch pad. It's not even fueled yet. It's just sitting on the launch pad. It's not going to launch for about 3 weeks. But the three Apollo astronauts are up inside the capsule that day, and they're going through a routine checklist, getting familiar with the capsule, getting ready for launch, when all of a sudden a spark came out from underneath one of the chairs. It ignited with the pure oxygen inside the Apollo capsule, and a fire broke out. Well, the fire burned so hot and so fast that the astronauts could not get the hatch door open, and all three of the astronauts burst in the fire. It was Gus Grissom, Roger Chaffetz, and Ed White, who had done our first spacewalk. Now everyone in the country, all of America, was stunned. They were in mourning. The people at NASA are thinking, how are we possibly getting to the moon? We can't even keep our astronauts safe on an empty rocket that took us to the moon on the Saturn V rocket. They call it the Saturn V because it used five of those engines. So that means we put out 7.5 million pounds of thrust. If you want to convert that to horsepower, that's 160 million horsepower. Sure. And that's crazy. There's only 7 million horses on the whole planet. Well, that was the most powerful rocket ever launched in the history of man. Until November 16th at 1:47 a.m. and 44 seconds, when we launched Artemis 1. Artemis 1 puts out 8.8 million pounds of thrust, and now that is the most powerful rocket ever launched. That last rocket back here, this turquoise one in the corner, that is called the Delta II rocket. If you came here today and you use GPS in your car or on your phone, you may want to go to shake hands with that rocket. Because that's the one that put all those GPS satellites up into orbit for us. They also launched two of our rovers up to Mars. In total, 155 missions it flew. It's a real workhorse. 29 years that covered. Last launch, not that long ago, just back in 2018. Every time we have a GPS launch, they put that big decal up top there as a tribute to the Flying Tigers of World War II. And that's up toward the Rocket Garden. So thank you for joining me. If anyone has any questions, I'll try and answer them. Show you that.
Is pretty tiny in there. It's like a Volkswagen or something.
Yeah.
He's a little X-wingy there in the cockpit. A lot of astronauts. Be damned. More than I can count. And we made our way into one of many gift shops here at the Kennedy Space Center. It has this kind of neat bridge going through the middle. That is a pretty cool addition to the gift shop. Sweet little bridge. Not bad. Not a normal size shot glass.
That's like my Harley shot glass that I have, which is way too big.
I'm drunk. I need my space.
And
Oh man, this thing is giant. That looks super weird.
So that's the real Atlantis? Another gift shop. That's not even the same gift shop.
Yeah, I think it's probably a couple miles out.
Yeah, I wonder how big just that flag is, even. It's probably as big as like its own building.
Parked here on the causeway at New Smyrna Beach. And as you can see, a lot of other people have stopped here. We're gonna have ourselves a space launch. I think we're gonna have a good view of it just off in that direction. This is really like the one high point in all of Florida. Greg's got the appropriate shirt on. We're not fucking around.
Oh man,
there's supposed to be a launch yesterday when we did Kennedy Space Center. It got pushed back to today, but here in the next 5 minutes or so, see something cool.
Before that, dolphin sighting there underneath us.
Oh, there it goes.
There she is. Oh, God, that's almost too bright to look at. Oh, my God, that is too bright to look at.
Yeah. It's quite blinding.
Oh, man.
Damn.
Oh, my God.
Damn, it's already curving.
Oh, yeah. So putting as much pressure on the flame coming out the back. It's getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Look at that.
Oh, there's the trail. Oh,
there you go. Starts to light up because the sun's hitting it. Oh my God, that looks incredible. Oh my God, that's amazing.
That's fucking cool.
Separation. You can see the two. Oh yeah. There's the two side boosters.
Yep.
These they'll fucking turn around and dogleg back down the Canaveral. Space.
Man, look at that.
Oh, dude, that's so cool.
So crazy to see this in person. Ah, Greg and I have always wanted to do this. For now, heading up north a little bit, heading to Daytona Beach for the night. Hotel there, so explore a little nightlife. Right, this place looks pretty promising. A bunch of bars, nightlife, got some late night restaurants, gentlemen's club. Definitely a fun night doing it up out here in Daytona, Florida style. I get to enjoy a nice East Coast sunrise. Don't get that at home. Appreciate you watching. Stay tuned for the next one.